most about Tarifa?
3 weeks of 40 knots Levante. That is even too much to go out to get a coffee. That happens a lot too. What, you gotta stay inside and drink coffee. Or go to Palmones, which we're doing now, and get a gusty session, but still better than 40 knots in Tarifa, so. Yeah, I think a lot of people don't know that it's actually good for kind of everything in the winter as well. Like, people really see it as a kind of like a summer destination, which it clearly isn't, and that's what I like a lot. I'm Stefan Spiessberger. We are just now in Tarifa here, and I'm 30 years old. Whoa, 30 years old. No, I think I just said that for the first time somewhere. It feels old, huh? Well, when I was young, I didn't really actually dream about becoming like a pro kiteboarder. I mean, and then I got really into it, so it kind of just progressed really good and did some comps, did well in there. And then, of course, it became a goal of mine to maybe make a living out of kiting one day. And obviously, I achieved that now, and it's really sick, but I also think it's not really everything at all in life. Like, I think the most important is just to really be at a place with yourself and live at a place where you can just do what you want, what you feel like passionate about, and not feeling like being trapped somewhere in a... That's the goal for me, I think, to really also in the future get to a place with myself and also maybe with life, with work, to be still able to be on the water or maybe be in the mountains. When you are like 18 years old and you live in a town with like 5,000 people living there, no proper bars to go out and stuff, like all you want to do is just, yeah, I want to move to a city or move away from here. And like when I was 18, I didn't see that I can kite and ski in spring on the same day if it's a good day. And now I'm like, whoa, that's actually what I want to do, and just make use of that. Home in Austria for quite a while, trying to get my shoulder back in place. Quite a shitty timing, actually. Like, I wasn't really sure about competing and stuff, so I was kind of thinking actually to make maybe Mauritius my last event. And then I popped out my shoulder, and I really didn't wanna stop like this. And now I'm actually really keen again to not only to do some contests, but also to just go and kite for myself and have a good time, you know, just look beyond competing. And yeah, I was always planning to kind of study something online, but I kind of pushed it and always kind of kept it there until I probably would have seen the end of my career coming. The injury, of course, reminded me a little bit on that. I just really had time to do it and also wanted to have something to not think about kiting all the time. Even now where I'm back on the water and I'm planning to compete and go filming next year, I think even now studying will help me with kiting as well. I think it's kind of good to do something useful with the time you have, also something useful for the future.